My name's Dr. James O'Donovan, and in this video, you're going to learn key things you need to know about a medication called amlodipine, which is a type of medication called a calcium channel blocker, and it's used to treat high blood pressure. If you've got high blood pressure, taking amlodipine can help to prevent future heart disease, heart attacks, as well as strokes. It's also used to prevent chest pain that's caused by heart disease known as angina. Amlodipine helps to treat high blood pressure by relaxing and widening blood vessels. This in turn lowers your blood pressure and makes it easier for your heart to pump blood around your body. With angina, you'll usually get chest pain because the arteries going to the heart have become hardened and narrowed. Amlodipine helps by improving the blood and oxygen supply to your heart, and this medication is only available on prescription, meaning that you'll need to see your doctor for it, and it comes as tablets or as a liquid that you can swallow. In this video, we're going to cover who can and can't take it, how and when to take it, side effects, potential interactions with other medications, and finally, common questions and where you can find more information out about this medication. So let's start off with who can as well as can't take it. Well, most adults and children aged 6 and over can take amlodipine if it's been prescribed by their health provider. However, amlodipine is not suitable for everyone. To make sure that it's safe for you, you should tell your doctor if you've ever had an allergic reaction to amlodipine or any other similar medication, you've got liver or kidney disease, or if you've got heart failure or you've recently had a heart attack. So how and when should you take it? Well, in terms of how to practically take amlodipine, always follow your doctor's instructions and read the instructions on the information leaflet that comes with the medication before starting to take it. If you're unsure about anything, don't hesitate to ask your doctor or pharmacist. In terms of how much to take, well, amlodipine comes in 2 tablet sizes, 5 mg and 10 milligrams. There's also a liquid form which is available in 2 strengths, 5 mg in 5 mL and 10 milligrams in 5 mL. Usually you'll start with 5 mg once a day, but again, this will depend on a case-by-case basis on what your doctor prescribes for you. Now the dose might need to be adjusted. If the 5 mg isn't doing the trick, like if your blood pressure stays high or you're still having chest pain, your doctor might increase the dose to 10 milligrams. Your doctor will keep an eye on your blood pressure and ask about any side effects to figure out the best dose for you, and children's doses are usually lower than adult doses. In terms of how and when to take it, typically you'll take amlodipine once every day, and it helps to take it at the same time each day. It's fine to take it with or without eating, and I'd recommend that you swallow the tablets whole with some water. If you need to, you can dissolve the tablet in water, but drink it all immediately. If you have the liquid, use the special spoon or syringe that comes with the medicine to measure your dose. A regular kitchen teaspoon won't give you the right amount. It's also worth mentioning that you shouldn't mix amlodipine with grapefruit juice because it can make side effects potentially worse. In terms of how long you take the amlodipine for, amlodipine is usually something that you will take for a long time, maybe even for life. Don't stop taking it without talking to your doctor first, because stopping suddenly can cause your blood pressure to spike, therefore increasing your risk of a heart attack and a stroke. If side effects are bothering you, your doctor might have other options for you, or they may lower the dose. Now, if you forget to take a dose, take it as soon as you remember that day. But if you've missed the whole day, just skip it and take your next dose at the regular time. Never take 2 doses at the same time. Now, if you're forgetting to take it often, setting an alarm or getting advice from your pharmacist can help you to remember. Now, remember, these are general guidelines that I'm giving you. Your specific situation might be different, so always stick to what your own healthcare provider advises, because this is intended as a general educational video and not an individual clinical advice video. So now that we've covered practical issues about how to take amlodipine, let's cover potential side effects, because just like any other medication, amlodipine might cause side effects for some people, but not everyone will experience them. Now, if you do have side effects that are bothering you or they don't seem to go away, it's a good idea to chat with your doctor or pharmacist. They might suggest a lower dose or maybe a different type of medication. Now, when you start taking amlodipine, you might have some side effects, but the good news is they usually get better as your body adjusts the medication. Now, common side effects happen in more than 1 in 100 people, but they are usually mild and short-lived. You might feel headaches, dizziness, a red, warm face, strong, fast heartbeats, as well as swollen ankles. Now, if these bother you or they don't go away in a few days, talk to your doctor or pharmacist. They can give you tips on how to deal with these side effects. On the other hand, serious side effects are rare, but they're important to know about. These can include severe stomach pain with or without diarrhea or vomiting, which could be a pancreas problem. You might also have yellow eyes or skin. This is known as jaundice, and this could be a sign of liver issues. Or chest pain that doesn't go away in a few minutes, especially if it's new or worse. This could be a heart attack. If you experience any of these, seek urgent medical attention. Finally, very rarely, it can cause a severe allergic reaction called anaphylaxis, which can cause issues with the tongue and lips swelling, as well as difficulty breathing. If this is the case, you need to seek emergency medical attention immediately because, like I said, this could be life-threatening. Remember, this is not a full list of side effects, and to find out more, always read the information leaflet fully. So now let's briefly look at some other potential interactions with other medications that you might be taking. So this is just to let you know that some other medicines can interfere with how amlodipine works. Now, if you're taking medications for high blood pressure, like ramipril or lisinopril, or you start taking amlodipine, your blood pressure might drop too much. You might feel dizzy, like you're about to faint. Now, if this happens often, you should tell your doctor, because they again might need to adjust the dose that they prescribed you. Some medicines can also change how amlodipine works, and it's really important to tell your doctor if you're taking certain antibiotics like clarithromycin, erythromycin, or rifampicin, other blood pressure medications like diltiazem or verapamil, antifungal medications like itraconazole or ketoconazole, medications for HIV or hepatitis C, and anti-epilepsy drugs like carbamazepine, phenytoin, or primidone. It's also worth mentioning to your doctor if you're taking immune system suppressants like cyclosporine or tacrolimus, or more than 20 milligrams a day of the cholesterol medication simvastatin. Finally, some people take a herbal remedy for depression called St. John's Wort. It might affect how your amlodipine works, so if this is the case, talk to your doctor if you're taking it. Remember, always check with your doctor before starting any new medication or supplements, especially supplements that you buy over the counter whilst taking amlodipine, to make sure everything is safe and won't cause problems with your blood pressure or the effectiveness of the medication. So finally, let's finish off with some commonly asked questions that I hope will help you. So the first commonly asked question is, how long does amlodipine take to work? Well, amlodipine starts to work on the day you start taking it, but it might be a couple of weeks before it takes full effect. If you're taking amlodipine for high blood pressure, you may not have any symptoms. In this case, you may not feel any different when you take the amlodipine. This doesn't mean that the medicine is not working, so it's important that you keep taking it. If you're taking amlodipine for angina, it will probably take a couple of weeks before you feel better. Until then, you may still get chest pains sometimes, and you might even find the pain gets worse to start with. But if you ever get severe chest pain that doesn't stop after a few minutes, or is new or worse than your chest pain caused by angina, this is a possible sign of a heart attack, and it needs to be checked out as soon as possible, so you need to seek emergency medical attention straight away. The other question that is commonly asked is, can I drink alcohol whilst taking amlodipine? Well, the answer is yes, you can drink alcohol with amlodipine, but drinking alcohol can make amlodipine lower your blood pressure more than you need. This can make you feel sleepy or dizzy or bring on a headache. If this happens to you, it's best to stop drinking alcohol whilst you're taking amlodipine. Now, for more information about amlodipine, including specific issues around pregnancy, breastfeeding, as well as fertility, please check out the links I've included in the description box of this video. If you've got any questions, please do reach out in the comments section. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my channel for weekly medical education videos. Once again, thanks for watching, and bye.